Hello students, now we are going to discuss the very important topic in carbon and its compounds, that is soap and detergent. Already we have discussed regarding the preparation and properties of ethanol, acetic acids. So this is the last part of this chapter, that is soaps and detergent. It is also very much essential knowledge for your competitive examination and for your also CBSE examination. So let us start from soap. Soap generally, it is a sodium or potassium salt of long chain fatty acids. This is very important term, that is long chain fatty acid. That means higher carbon chain. The acid containing longer carbon chain, that is, these are called fatty acids. Generally, commonly fatty acids are stearic acid, oleic acids, and palmitic acid. These are the higher fatty acids, long chain fatty acids. So, soap generally, it is a sodium or potassium salt or of potassium salt of higher fatty acids. Generally, a soap is prepared from fat and oil, from vegetable oil or from fat also we can prepare soap. And the method is called saponification. This method is called saponification. This is called saponification. So by saponification method, soap is extracted from, it is prepared from oil and fat. Oil and fat generally called as triglycerides. These are called triglycerides. These are the ester, triester. You see, this is one ester, this is one ester, and it is also one ester. That is three ester attached to this carbon chain. So it is called triester, or these are called triglycerides. So these are some, don't think it is higher knowledge. It is essential for you, for your competitive examination, okay? So this triester or triglyceride, these are called oil or fat. When these triglycerides, or that is you take vegetable oil, when treated with sodium hydroxide, aqueous sodium hydroxide, then the solution will be heating. When the triglycerides, or that is triester, these are oil or fats, when mixed with sodium hydroxide, then the mixture will be heated, then you will get a salt, sodium or potassium salt. If you take sodium hydroxide, you will get sodium salt. If you take potassium hydroxide, you will get potassium salt. And this salt is called soap. So soap is a sodium or potassium salt of higher fatty acid. For example, you take, this is the triester, this is called stearin. This is called stearin. It is one triester, triglycerides, that is one oil, name is stearin. When it is mixed with sodium hydroxide on heating, it produces glycerol. This is glycerol. Glycerol or glycerin, and along with a sodium salt is precipitated. This sodium salt name is sodium stearate. It is called sodium stearate. As it is produced from stearin triglycerides, so it is called sodium stearate. Formula is C17H35COONA, salt, sodium salt. So this is called sodium stearate. One soap, one example of soap. So soap is prepared, the method is called saponification. This is called saponification, preparation of soap from ester. Generally we have read in acid and alcohol chapter, when ester is hydrolyzed in presence of base, it produces sodium salt of acid and alcohol. Here same example. Here is a ester triglyceride, when treated with sodium hydroxide on heating, it produces alcohol, that is glycerol, and salt, that is sodium stearate. So this is the one example of preparation of soap, industrial method. This is called industrial method. इंडस्ट्रियल मेथड, ओके इंडस्ट्रियल मेथड, इंडस्ट्रियल मेथड प्रिपरेशन ऑफ सोप. सो जनरली व्हाट आर द टाइप्स ऑफ सोप? ऑलरेडी यू हैव डिस्कस, सोप कैन बी प्रिपेयर्ड फ्रॉम सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड और इट प्रिपेयर्ड फ्रॉम पोटेशियम हाइड्रोक्साइड. सो इट मे बी ए सोडियम सॉल्ट और मे बी ए पोटेशियम सॉल्ट. सो टाइप्स ऑफ सोप इफ यू डिस्कस, जनरली टॉयलेट सोप, वन एग्जाम्पल इज टॉयलेट सोप, दैट इज बैथिंग सोप वी कैन से. इट इज मेनली बेटर ग्रेड्स, इट इज प्रिपेयर्ड यूजिंग बेटर ग्रेड फैट्स एंड ऑयल्स, एंड सैंड केयर इज टेकन टू रिमूव द एक्सेस अल्कली. इफ तो एक्सेस अल्कली इज रिमेन, इट शुड बी रिमूव. एंड द कलर परफ्यूम्स ऑल्सो एडेड, द कलर ऑल्सो चेंजेस एंड परफ्यूम ऑल्सो एडेड. सो इट इज मोर एक्टिव, मोर अट्रैक्टिव एंड ऑल्सो मोर कॉस्टलियर. सो टॉयलेट सोप, दैट इज वी कैन से बैथिंग सोप, दिस इज द प्रिपेयर्ड फ्रॉम हाई ग्रेड फैट्स एंड ऑयल्स एंड द अल्कली, एक्सेस अल्कली मस्ट बी रिमूव. देन ट्रांसपेरेंट सोप, सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल इज ट्रांसपेरेंट सोप. ट्रांसपेरेंट सोप मीन्स द इट इज ट्रांसपेरेंट, क्लियरली विजिबल. मेनली इट इज ऑब्टेन्ड ड्यू बाय द क्रिस्टलाइजेशन इन अल्कोहल. When the soap is crystallized, when soap is precipitated using alcohol as a solvent, then you will get a what? Transparent soap. So this is called transparent. Like your glycerin soap, it is transparent because it is extracted, it is precipitated from alcohol. You remember. Then medicated soap, like you know that you already know Dettol, Savlon. So these are the medicated soap, which contain different that antiseptic agent is used. So Dettol, Savlon can be added to the medicated soap. Then shaving soap. Shaving soap mainly contain glycerol, mainly it contain mole glycerol, because glycerol keeps the skin wet, not it prevent rapid drying. So that skin will not be dry. That's why glycerol is added more. So and gum called rosin is also added while making them. It forms more leather, more foam is produced. Sodium rosinate also used. Sodium rosinate also used. So it produces more foams, leather. Okay. So shaving soap, medicated soap, transparent soap, toilet soap, like this. Laundry soap. Laundry soap means it is mainly used for cleaning cloths. So these are the mainly contains the filler like substance, that is sodium rosinate, sodium silicate, borax added, because it produces more foams, leather. So these are the different types of soap. So soaps also, some soaps also floats on water because it contains some air bubbles. During preparation of soap, if it contains air bubbles in the crystal, then it floats on water. Then what are the advantages of soap? First advantage is, it is main remember, it is a good cleaning agent. Then it is known, that is, it is mainly biodegradable. That means it do not cause water pollution. This is very important, that it do not produce water pollution, 100% biodegradable and also good cleaning agent. Then what are the disadvantages of soap? Disadvantages, if you see, main disadvantage is we cannot use soap in hard water. Hard water means water containing calcium ion, magnesium ion, mainly these two, calcium ion, magnesium ion mainly responsible to harness water. If water contain any calcium salt or magnesium salt, this is called hard water. Okay, hard water, if you use hard water in cleaning purposes, then what happens? As soap is a sodium salt, then what happens? This sodium salt reacts with calcium ion, forming precipitate of calcium salt. which is water insoluble. Suppose you take sodium stearate as a soap, then produce calcium stearate, water insoluble, magnesium stearate, also water insoluble. So these type of salt, calcium, magnesium is produced when you use hard water, because hard water contain calcium ion, magnesium ion. When it mix, when you add soap solution, then there will be reaction between calcium ion and soap. Soap is contain sodium salt, so double displacement reaction takes place. You can say double displacement reaction takes place. What happens due to double displacement? What happens? Calcium salt, magnesium salt, insoluble salt is produced. That is called SCOM. That is called SCOM. So due to formation of SCOM, then what happens? It gets precipitated. So we cannot use the hard water for cleaning purposes. So soap cannot use in hard water. So this is very important. Cannot use hard water because it produces insoluble salt with calcium and magnesium ion. Remember, this is very important for your examination. Then come to detergent. Detergent, one type of cleaning agent. It is also important for your day-to-day life. But one thing is, detergent is better cleaning agent than soap. It is better cleaning agent than soap. Remember, this is very important. Detergent is better cleaning agent than soap. Then what are the detergent? It is also salt like your soap, but what type of salt? It is a long chain alkyl benzene sulfonic acid. That means the salt of sulfonic acid containing longer chain, having aromatic ring, that is benzene ring, and or a sodium salt of long chain alkyl hydrogen sulfate. Already you see these two examples. This example is a sodium salt of long chain alkyl benzene sulfonic acid. It is second one is, what is the second example? Second example is sodium salt of alkyl hydrogen sulfate. That is CH3CH2 11SO4. This is the sulfate, so sodium salt. So salt of sulfonic acid. Salt of sulfonic acid. This is the salt of sulfuric acid derivative. So sulfuric acid derivative means alkyl, long chain alkyl hydrogen sulfate. This is the salt of alkyl hydrogen sulfate. So these are two, first one and second one, both are the example of detergent. These substances are highly soluble in water. So that is sodium dodecyl benzene sulfonate, the name, if you remember the name, that is better than sodium lauryl sulfate. One is containing aromatic ring, that is benzene. This is called benzene. This part is benzene. Benzene. Okay. And this is the long chain alkyl group. And this is the long chain alkyl group containing benzene ring. So these are two types of detergent. One is alkyl benzene sulfonic acid salt. Another is alkyl long chain alkyl hydrogen sulfate salt. Okay, these are two types of detergent. But detergent generally is better cleaning agent, but it is main demerits. Disadvantage is it causes water pollution. It causes water pollution. This is very important thing. Mainly detergent causes water pollution, but soap does not produce water pollution. But cleaning property is better than your soap. Then there are generally detergent is prepared from detergent having prepared from long chain hydrocarbon should be a straight chain prepared from. If it is prepared from straight chain hydrocarbon, then it will be cause less pollution. But if it is a branch chain, then very difficult to decompose. That's why. So if detergent is a branch chain hydrocarbon, then it causes more water pollution. If it is a straight chain, then causes less pollution. So one is biodegradable, another is non-biodegradable. Non-biodegradable means it causes water pollution. Biodegradable means it do not produce water pollution. So detergent should be prepared from long straight chain hydrocarbon, but it should not be branch. If it will be branch, then it causes water pollution, it is non-biodegradable. Then very important thing, washing action of soap and detergent, how the soap used for cleaning purposes, how it is works, how it is function for cleaning purposes. If you see the structure of soap, soap is a long chain hydrocarbon, this is the long chain hydrocarbon, and it has two part. The tail is called hydrophobic, and head, this is head, this is your head, this is your tail. This part is a tail, carbon chain tail, and it is water insoluble, that's a hydrophobic, and this is water soluble, this is water soluble, water soluble, this is water insoluble. This is the difference. Tail is water insoluble, but head is water soluble. This is called hydrophilic and it is hydrophobic. So, and it is structural, it has two part, hydrophilic and hydrophobic. Head mainly contains your minus charge, and here CO minus, like this. So head, and this part is long carbon chain, which is water insoluble. But when it will mix with water, when soap will be added to water, then soap molecule, as it has long carbon chain and another, it has ions, one that head contain charge ions, that is negative charge mainly, and tail is your carbon chain, long carbon chain. So what happens when it will mix with water, then produce micelle. Micelle is a associated soap molecule, and it is produced due to combination of different soap molecule. You see the structure, this is the example of what, that is micelle. How now, these are the smaller, you see, these are the chain soap molecules. That chain is hydrophobic, and the head, this is the head, and these are the heads, and these are the carbon chain. This carbon chain, what happens, associated one another, they combine one another, but the head is soluble in water. These are the soluble in water mainly. Head will be water soluble, but tail is water insoluble. But tail will combine one another, forming a micelles, associated molecule. High associated molecule means large number of soap molecule combined together, forming micelles. What are the micelles? When large number of soap molecule combined together, forming micelles. How they produce micelles? The carbon chain, long carbon chain mixed together, and the head, it mixed with water, and tail combine one other, and forming micelles. When the micelles form, a cavity is formed. This is the cavity. This is called cavity. Cavity. Due to formation of cavity, then when it will apply to dirty substance or then oil, then the oil drops will be attracted to this point. At the cages, at the cavity, at the hole, this oil will be attracted. It will be trapped at the gaps in the cavity, so that easily remove from the cloths or utensil. So soap acts, the washing action of soap mainly depends upon the formation of micelles. When the micelles is formed, then soap and dirty substance, these are called coherent substance, can be easily removed from the cloths. So first the soap molecule will be dissolved in water, then the soap molecules combine one another, forming micelles. These are called associated colloids. These are called also associated colloid. Associated colloid, and these associated colloid form, these are called micelles, and the micelles has a cavity, that is gap. At this gap, the dirty substance oil becomes trapped so that it will be easily separated from the clothes. So in this way, the dirty substance can be removed from the clothes, and the oily substance can remove from the utensil. So these are the washing action of soap and detergent. The washing action of soap and detergent mainly depends upon the formation of micelles. The micelles is produced at a particular concentration. If more water is added, then micelles formation will not be formed. Generally, the micelles will not be formed. The quality of micelles will be low, but with a minimum concentration, then generally at a particular high concentration, then micelles will be formed. When the micelles will be formed, then the dirty substance and your oily substance can be easily removed from the clothes. So these are the application of, that is the cleaning action of soap and detergent. So I hope you have understood this topic, soap and detergent. You have some knowledge regarding soap and detergent, how soap and detergent used for washing action, what are the difference of soap and detergent. So any doubt you have, you can send your questions in the comment box. And if you have not subscribed the channel, please subscribe the channel and share the video to your friends and your relatives. Okay, thank you.